I hear an awful lot about like MR and VR and AR and all of these other, you know, TLAs of, you know, two or three letter abbreviations. So, you know, in a nutshell, what is MR, AR, VR? How do they relate to one another? Is there a difference? Like, what is all of this?
First of all, so sorry for making this super complicated. It's our fault. I mean, by us, I mean, most of the time it's the companies, right? Every company uses some different naming convention. Then it becomes very confusing after a while. So what we describe as, I will describe them all in once, I hope. So we are in the real world with the real objects, everything. So this is one end of the spectrum. And the other end of the spectrum is when everything is virtual, which means that you put on a headset, you don't see anything around you. The only thing that you see that is created 3D objects that are rendered with the software. So that is virtual reality when you're totally immersed and don't have any connection with the outside world. And there are so many things in between. Some of them are, you know, phone applications that we daily use, right? Snapchat was one of them, any kind of filters, like visual filters. And now Google Maps has a great augmented reality capability feature, which, you know, shows like arrows on your own street, and you could see like which way you need to go. So, which is augmenting our reality. When I think of it, I think of like, I'm adding to this reality, adding something. And what we call mixed reality at Microsoft is this whole range of things. Anything from, you know, adding something small to your environment to totally being immersed into a virtual world.
Okay. So mixed reality then is sort of the umbrella, then the all-encompassing term. Mm-hmm. My virtual reality is I'm putting on those headphones, and now this is like literally all that I see and all that I'm interacting with. And mm-hmm. that augmented reality is when I'm looking through something that's mm-hmm. now like adding objects or arrows or other things that you mentioned that aren't actually there.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. And that's not all, unfortunately. So on the web, we have this device APIs called WebXR. And they used to be called WebVR because at the time, we only had the virtual reality devices. And nobody thought about, you know, augmented reality glasses or phones having these capabilities. So after a while, when we realized that, you know, this is going to be a problem, we changed from WebVR to WebXR. X meaning any variable, which is, you know, we might end up with other realities that we don't know, we haven't discovered yet, but we would like to cover all of that with WebXR term on the web.
Okay. And besides, if you add the letter X to it, it just means that it's cooler. That's like, I think, yes, how that works. So.
Exactly. And mysterious, obviously.
Obviously.
Yeah.